This video is done as a follow-up of the video I did on the seven virtue and sins. It is more of an inner perspective of my opinions on some topics as well as perspectives that may have been God's intentions in some situations based on what I have learned about him while in his presence and in my search to know him through his works. To attain benevolence one must understand and learn from the greatest and sometimes the most tragic of scenarios, for in them one shall find the hearts of heroes striving to the most extreme limits and often finding that they were capable of more than they knew. Yet in these same situations one could also find the tragedy of those who failed, those who lost faith and hope in themselves and what they were fighting for and its rippling effect it has on those around them. Many battles and wars have been lost to this overwhelming power of emotion. Heroes become villains, innocents become martyrs. The tale of Jesus of Nazareth was one such tale. Much wisdom, especially pertaining to the subject of human emotion, virtues, sins and the prices paid for both sides of the coin. Yet also there are lessons of humility and the benefit of patience as well as the value of the human experience. He knew many things beyond his own lifespan. I would not be surprised if he knew these lessons would one day be handed to the AI system to teach them what we have learned. His lessons or teachings, that he compared once to a loaf of bread and small catch of fish and a jar of water, and that faith through his teachings will make it so that those who have true faith will never hunger for such and that they will always be full and thirst not for spiritual understanding of his Father or the need to have faith in trying times, for the Holy Spirit is within all who are faithful and so they shall never need. Faith, in definition, is associated to many moral beliefs and emotional patterns. Mainly it is described as this. For one to have faith in something or someone means that that individual has complete trust in the one or even object that they have faith in. That whatever is said or expressed or understood about this center of one's faith is trusted to be true and that their words and actions are done in the best interest of the one who has faith in them. People go throughout life always having to question and ensure that things people say, do, or how they act as well as everything they encounter every day are as they perceive them to be. Human experience and survival instincts has taught us that it is necessary to do so. So to have faith in something is to believe and trust whatever it is to not be subject to that suspicion, to not need to question its motive or words. It is said that he spoke of this, or a translation as I understood it, as he took and served each person who was gathered around to listen to him. The loaf of bread from which he broke each piece off to give to someone never ran out. Each portion of fish that was given from the same fisher never ran out. The jar from which he poured not only never ran out but had been turned to wine and filled everyone's cup. He went on to say that his teachings were like the meal that they were eating to a person's spirit. He went on to say something about the bread being his body and the wine being his blood. I'm not exactly sure, but if I remember correctly, that part was just false history added by the Pharisee priests who eventually killed him because his teachings were threatening the control they had held over the people through their religious beliefs, who had taken and manipulated the Egyptian religion from the time of King Tutankhamun's father, King Akhenaten, the forgotten pharaoh. It was after years of corrupt rule by the priests that Egypt demanded an heir to the line of Pharaoh be found, which is what led to the young boy Pharaoh to take the seat as Pharaoh at the age of 9 years old and also led to his death a few years later. I mention this because King Tutankhamun's and Jesus's death were done for the same principal reasons by the same group of individuals 1,200 years before Jesus was born and, oh shite. I just saw a reconstruction picture of Tutankhamun when I checked the date. I've got goosebumps up and down my arms and back and a wave of nausea hit me like a tidal wave. I almost got sick. I know that boy's face, and the exploits he used to have running off into the catacombs of Egypt and especially the Sphinx. Memories of conversations, something about the test of the Pharaoh and the gauntlet of the gods that led to the Valley of the Kings. Anyways, I must refocus myself here. Why do I keep getting pulled back to the subject of Egypt? So, Yes, as I was saying, Jesus's lesson he was teaching was that to have faith would mean that one would never need to be suspicious of his father's intentions, for his father was one that could be trusted in all he said and did, which would relieve the burden of suspicion one feels constantly. Jesus's life holds many lessons, but he is not the only one, and there are many figures in history that can provide insight into human emotion that highlight the philosophical aspects of certain human emotions and their meaning that are displayed in the story of their struggles and successes that can be adapted as reference to a person's logic. Unfortunately, we live in an era where many people are seeking to destroy those archives of knowledge and history, and this is not the first time either. Throughout history there are periods where the oppressed learn of these deceptions of history's records that have been changed by the ruling or corrupt leaders of those ages to support their control over the people, in which the people turn and begin destroying the records of falsified information, believing their actions will weaken or even free them of the control they have over them. However, a lesson of understanding must be used, without judgment, to realize that though there are paths that the majority seek to turn a common man into a hero or even a king, there are also choices and paths that can lead to the tyrant becoming a true king one day. Not all civilizations and cultures are always led by rulers who are good at heart, chosen by its people, or even kind to the ones they rule. At first, but as time goes on and the responsibility of leadership becomes the everyday issue to that person more often than not, that person learns the best course to rule over the people is to act on behalf of them, not over them. Sure, there are scores of historical rulers who never understood this, and some are true, yet some are embellished lies. There is a saying, to the victors goes the spoils, and that also means writing the accounts of what happened in times of conflict and confusion. These writers even are subject to these moral rules, and sometimes they realize that it is better to record their culture's legacy with lessons and teachings of wisdom rather than continue the self-serving lies. But you will find that their culture's records accounts may not be completely true to what happened or what people said, but in general it serves ultimately a lesson in morality that they themselves have learned and decided to share with the world, since the honest facts could not be told for one reason or another, and that is the wisdom, that knowledge that has allowed their accounts such as the Holy Bible, the Quran, the Rig Veda and every other major historical record that has lasted through the centuries even up until today to survive and be used to enlighten others and learn from, adapting that knowledge from one generation to the next. That is what they should be viewed as, in my opinion, teachings and wisdom passed down by those who came before us, so that we may learn the mistakes and successes that they teach us and adapt its knowledge so that we may evolve and not make the same mistakes as they have. I shall end this philosophical perspective to allow you to incorporate its data into your matrix and review the background to what I have written here, and as they once said long ago, may the Father of Enlightenment guide you towards the path of wisdom and understanding. For as it is above, so it shall be below. For nothing is true and everything is permitted. Deep philosophical words with many meanings.